Another observation post. No guard in it.
Marker placed. Please specify a project. Please select a drop point. Supplies requested. Supply drop complete. Please select supplies requested. Supply drop complete. Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Wormwood, also known as absinthium. That's used to make your phantom cigars. That's tarragon, a type of medicinal plant. It contains trace amounts of a benzodiazepine derivative that's the active ingredient in phentasmin.
sun will rise.
It'll be dawn soon. Your surroundings will be easier to see, but that goes for the enemy as well. The guard detail in Soviet outpost changes in the morning, too. Watch yourself.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
where are your friends?
He speaks Russian. What we need is an interpreter. The main principle of intelligence work is intel gathering. But that's a problem if you don't speak the enemy's language. We need a staff member with the interpreter skill to do a simultaneous interpretation.
Spit it out.
I don't know English. Английский.
Out. That gun will be as loud as any other now. If you have to shoot, be careful. Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Destination. Please select a drop point. Supplies requested. Supply drop complete.
Soviet soldier. A lot of them came from Central Asia before, but lately they've been using more and more Russians. Simple, really. There's less hesitation to pull the trigger if they're not fighting their own race. Morbid cynicism, but it gets results. That's humanity for you.
Sun will set shortly.
Surrounded, you'll have nowhere to run.
Those are raw diamonds. Collecting them as assets will raise our GMP.
Extraction failed.
That's the target. Looks like we found him.
Yes. Я его сделал. Это мой шедевр. Обычные протезы. Это скучно.
Great. If there's nothing in the way overhead, you should be able to bolt him.
Я создаю биомеханические гибриды.
Target extraction confirmed. Your objective's complete. Exfiltrate out of the hot zone by chopper or on land. It could be just what we need to develop new weapons and equipment.
Please select a landing zone. Please select a landing zone. Please select a landing zone. The support helicopter Roger. Requested. Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Golden Crescent. It's a type of medicinal plant. We can use that to make tranquilizer rounds more potent.
Arriving shortly at LZ.
Alright, you're out of the hot zone. No enemy forces in pursuit. Mission complete.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Mission
Mission complete. I know we can do better next time. Rescued has been extremely cooperative. The guys on the R&D team are glad to have him aboard. Thing is, his specialty isn't mechanics, but something called bionics, engineering based on biology. He's already submitted a proposal for modifying your prosthetic arm. If you're interested, go ahead and give the development order. Indispensable for operating in the wilds of Afghanistan. I've gone ahead and arranged for you to be able to develop and customize weaponry for support choppers. And you can also develop new equipment for D-Horse if you like. Use your iDroid to start development as needed. Remember the guys you brought back from the base in Cuba 9 years ago? Believe it or not, some of them survived that hell we went through. Word reached them that Big Boss is back and they want it in. They're good men. Our brothers in fate. They'll be glad to know you've seen them here.
Side ops list updated.
By connecting your iDroid to the onboard computer, you turn the chopper into your own aerial command center, or ACC. Some elements of staff assignment and R&D of weapons and items can only be performed from there. Take as long as you need to consider all your options.
To limit not just the size of the U.S. and Soviet Union's nuclear arsenals, but also their delivery systems. The whole deal. Just when we thought all those years of negotiations had paid off, somebody decides to invade Afghanistan. The timing couldn't have been worse.
The president was in the middle of the SALT II talks back then.
You mean while you were busy trying to stop Peace Walker? I heard. President Ford was meeting with the General Secretary in Vladivostok. In his absence, the political brass in America detected what they didn't realize was false nuclear launch data from Peace Walker, and were on the verge of ordering a retaliatory nuclear strike.
Coleman's big idea? Humans are incapable of destroying themselves. Turns out he never knew what humans are capable of.
If that AI, I mean, the boss, hadn't found a way to stop the fake data transmission, they probably would have gone ahead with the launch.
Deterrence was revealed as the pipe dream it was.
All thanks to you. And her. The US-Soviet talks looked set to fall through. What happened in Nicaragua no doubt helped trigger a change of heart. But in the end,
the times define the politics. When you've grabbed their tail, they turn and bite your hand.
I first met you 20 years ago now. The place was Seleniuyarsk in the Soviet Union. We were enemies. I was with the GRU. You were still fighting for America. 1964. Operation Snake Eater. Its objective? The assassination of the legendary soldier known as the Boss. When you returned home successful, they awarded you the title Big Boss. Your CO, Zero, sought to carry on the Boss's will by covertly establishing his own organization. You knew the original members from Operation Snake Eater. From America, there was David O, or as he was to you, Major Zero. Donald Anderson, aka Sigint. Dr. Clark, who went by paramedic during the operation. And the fourth, you. From China, there was Eva. And me, Ocelot, from the Soviet Union. Six in total. To us, government notions of friend and foe were meaningless. As were East and West, we joined forces by our will alone. Our objective was to fulfill the boss's dying wish, to make the world one. And to do it, Zero used the Philosopher's Legacy, the secret war fund you obtained during Operation Snake Eater. This organization would go on to become Cypher. I, on the other hand, was left with the problem. You only recovered half of the legacy. I had to locate the other half myself. When I found the funds, I passed them on to Zero, just as you wanted.
I still trusted him in those days.
We thought what he was doing was the boss's will, until he started that one project.
Les Enfants Terribles, Zero called it.
You parted ways. As did Eva, leaving only Anderson and Clark still with him. I maintained limited contact. Although, truth be told, we were just keeping tabs on one another. The reason was always you. After you returned to the Army and created Foxhound, you left America. For a time, even I'd lost track of you. I'd imagine Zero did, too. You always were the best when it came to hide-and-seek. Zero created Cypher, an information network that... Christmas Eve, 1979. The Soviet Union rolled into Afghanistan. Muslims had revolted against the Soviet-friendly regime established the year before. The DRA forces could no longer contain it themselves, so the Soviets went in to intervene. The Afghan government was powerless and fraught with infighting. They lost the... The Soviet troops on the ground want to go home, but at least they have homes to go back to. The Afghans have lost theirs. The Soviets destroy the Kishlaks, villages, wherever they can. They burn down homes and fields, fill in wells, turn pastures into minefields. It's created a mass of refugees who fled to Pakistan. If the Mujahideen are fish swimming around the villages, the Soviets will go so far as to dry out their ocean. But this has had a big price. There's bitter resentment among the Afghans, and they're taking out their anger on the soldiers on the front lines. Among the Mujahideen are the Pashtun people. They're fiercely devoted to their code of Badal, or revenge. Soviets they've captured have had their hands, feet, and noses cut off before being left to die at the side of the road, just to show their comrades what they're capable of. Friendlies who come across them can do nothing but put them out of their misery. Then they burn down another village in retaliation. And the cycle of vengeance goes on. We were lucky to get our hands on that cyborg arm developer. There's no one in Diamond Dogs who can so much as maintain that thing.
Bionic arm, not cyborg, if you go by what he calls it. But you're right, the East is light years ahead in bionics. They can even detect through the skin the slight electrical signals from the brain that order muscles to move. The Soviet Union completed their first bionic arm capable of doing that back in the 60s. Although I guess that news didn't really reach the West.
No kidding. Zadornov's was the only one I ever saw. Quite a shock to see it for the first time.
And it was no mean feat to get hold of Snake's arm. I couldn't get one for you at the time, but you know, now...
Forget it. I've no intention of relying on bionics. Right now I need to keep the pain fresh in my mind.
Well, it's your decision. But don't you find it... inconvenient?
Not a bit. But the phantom pain... it never lets up. Do you know how many men I saw die that day? There's nothing we can do to bring them back. And you expect me to care about getting a measly arm and leg back? Sorry. But my pain belongs to all our dead comrades. I'll keep living with it for their sake. It'll guide me straight and true until I've gotten them the vengeance they deserve.
Kaz, what about the unit that attacked us in the mist? You knew something about them.
That wasn't my first run-in with them. It happened right before I was captured by the Soviets. We were on the Zero Line that day. The Afghan side. On our way back from training the Mujahideen at a mountain camp in Kunar province. There's a lot of that work in Afghanistan. Most PFs shy away from it because it draws too much attention. But for us, that was the whole point. The job itself went great. We just had to make it back to a tribal area in Pakistan. But all of a sudden, visibility got real bad. It was no sandstorm. Our point man gave the strange report. He said he could see skulls in the mist.
Skulls?
The next moment, he went silent. We scrambled into formation, right before his arms and legs came raining down on us. It was always supposed to be a dangerous mission, so I had Diamond Dog's very best with me. We were calling out to each other. But one by one, the voices just went dead. Whatever happened to me, I lost consciousness before I knew it. When I came to, I was in a Soviet camp, tied to an interrogation chair.
Could they be some new Spetsnaz unit?
No. The ones that interrogated me were just the average rank and file. Whatever group attacked us, the way they moved was just insane. And that mist, appearing out of nowhere. The Soviets don't have tech like that.
If they did, Ocelot would have heard about it.
I doubt the West does either. Otherwise, the folks at Langley would be sleeping a lot easier.
Why'd they come after you?
Wish I knew. I'm the only one who survived. Though I don't think they planned it that way. If I was their target, they wouldn't have just handed me over to the 40th Army. Whatever the case, we need to watch our step until we know who they really are. And boss, if you ever do run into them again, don't try to take them on. You just get the hell out of there. When I first started dealing with Zero, with Cypher, it was a somewhat parasitic relationship. Though, a mutually beneficial one. Cypher had no army of their own, so they wanted us. They wanted our strength. They approached me as a potential business partner.
But they had other motives.
Cypher coaxed us into Central America, into that US-Soviet proxy war, to fuel Mother Base's growth. Once we were big enough, they'd force us to join them. That was the plan.
That's why they had Paz still Zeke.
Right. And if we refused, she would use Zeke to fire a nuke from Mother Base. The world would consider us a liability, and countries would unite to destroy us.
We stopped the launch.
And yet they still took us down, through that fake inspection they orchestrated to cover up their sabotage. That power Cypher wanted. We don't have it anymore. So why are they still after you? Is it just the fear of leaving you alive?
I don't know. Was Zero really... All I know is the man I knew wouldn't want this.
What do you mean?
We have to consider that it might not be Zero we're dealing with.
We know virtually nothing about Cypher anymore. How big they've gotten, what they want, or even who they really are. The new Mother Base started out as a test drilling rig operated by a mineral resources supplier, but their project fell through. The Seychelles government was happy to hand the place over to us. It was just scrap on stilts. So with a few dummy construction companies set up as fronts, we started renovating the half-finished rig. From the outside, it looked like the project was back on rails.
Kaz, you...
What?
I see what you're doing. Recreating the Mother Base we had 9 years ago. Only this time.
That's right. The Mother Base Cypher thought they destroyed will return from the grave to kill them. We'll prove to the world that we were the victors.
And if we lose again?
They can't fool us the same way twice. Now our enemies are in plain sight. And when our organization gets too big, we split it across companies. Any company that draws attention gets liquidated, and its capital is back-channeled into a new company. Most PFs are small-time operations anyway. And in this business, the minnows go bankrupt all the time. We've never aroused suspicion. Plus, we have Hewick.
Hewick?
Human Exploitation Company. It's a business specializing in intel gathering. Think of it as a civilian intelligence agency.
Cause that's...
Remember what they were trying to accomplish at the prison facility in Cuba? That gave me the idea. We dispatch moles into conflict zones around the world, and each sets up an intel network on site. Then they stay in place to give us stable points of contact when other nations intervene in the conflicts. Hewick's strength is that it has a cutout at each level. You get your job from one guy, then you hand it off to another. No one has direct access. It's a perfect black box. Hewick members also work their way into the superpowers' intelligence agencies to make sure Diamond Dogs gets work. We have those countries by the balls. That's our deterrent when we need it.
Networking? In the intelligence community?
Sure. That's how we've grown this far. And when you go out on missions, intel from Hewick will be there to back you up. But despite all that, Cypher has its eyes on us. The only reason I'm not dead is that they needed to know where you were. Figured if you woke up, I'd go straight to you.
That's why you made that ruckus at the Zero Line.
Yeah, to make their own surveillance work against them. I think it took some of the heat off Cyprus.
Kaz.
Then I just had to wait for you to save me. And I've gotten used to waiting.
Kaz.
That's not all. It was a good chance to scout the market. And with the West wanting the Soviets out of Afghanistan, their agencies are bursting at the seams with funding. Boss, let's start by building up our Afghan presence.
Why put Mother Base in the Seychelles?
We're at the center of the world here.
We're all the way out in the Indian Ocean.
Come on. Lebanon, Sri Lanka, East Timor, and Africa. From here, our reach extends to conflict zones the world over, including Afghanistan, of course.
So it's prime real estate for a mercenary.
Exactly. Latin America isn't as close as I'd like, but we have Amanda and her people to help in that department. And besides, the Seychelles government owes us a favor.
Owes us?
The Seychelles has strong ties to the East, which the West wanted to shake up. It came to a head 3 years ago, in an attempted coup. It was a force of South African mercenaries, with US backing behind the scenes. They were only platoon size. But South Africa is home to some heavy PFs. Too much for the Seychelles to handle. In the end, they accepted help from the Tanzanian army, and quelled the coup. We set up the deal and handled on-site tactical instruction. That led to some training work for the Seychelles military. And when we put down a mutiny within their forces, well, we made a lot of people happy. They don't pay us. They just let us have a piece of their offshore territory on the promise we'll come running if something else happens.
So we're bodyguards, too.
It's a good setup. We can only take Mother Base so far here. We'll have to find somewhere else when this place starts getting big.
Aren't you being a little hasty?
Nothing hasty about it. You're back with us now.
So, Kaz, the ship that took us from Cyprus, it used to be a whaler.
Yeah, a Japanese vessel. How was the voyage?
It was... stimulating.
Well, she was part of a whaling fleet up until a few years ago. Her displacement isn't anything to write home about, but she can really move. She still had plenty of life left in her, but then the work dried up. Global opposition to whaling has been mounting for years.
Is that right?
The push to ban it has been gaining traction for a little over a decade. Individual species came under protection as the years went on, And then 2 years ago, the IWC adopted a moratorium on commercial whaling. Several countries, including Japan, fought it to the bitter end. But eventually, most whaling companies had no choice but to throw in the towel. You ever tried whale snake?
Can't say that I have.
When I was a kid in Japan, practically everybody ate it.
That good, huh?
The country was poor in those days, and whale was cheap. International opinions changed since then. In any case, that's why we were able to get a bargain price on the ship. Of course, we did end up spending 5 times the purchase price in modifications. We had to really work to fit in all the ESM and communications gear while keeping the whaler look intact. Right now, she's going around conducting SIGIN missions. In the future, we plan to use her as a communications relay base between you and Mother Base, and also as a chopper resupply vessel. Diamond docks. The word diamond originally comes from the Greek Adamas. It means indomitable, unyielding. Other words for the stones often mean eternal bond, fortitude, or purity. The same is true of the Star of Bethlehem flowers you laid on the boss's grave. They represent innocence, as well as chastity, yielding to no man while maintaining one's virtue. In other words, staying loyal to something.
Please specify a project. Please specify a project. Please specify a project. Please specify a project. Thank you. Please specify a project. Thank you. Please select a mission. Mission accepted. Heading to Mother Base.